alumni, comedian, radio personality, and foodie. He's here to uncover the Philippine diaspora in the culinary world and how it differs from region to region. We're going to chat with him all today. Aloha, Lanai.
Aloha. Thanks for
Aloha.
Having me.
Thanks for coming back to Adobo Nation.
Happy
I'm excited
New Year.
To see you. Happy New Year. And you came back from a very busy holiday season, because right before that I was following your Instagram, living through your stories vicariously, and you were all over the Philippines, basically. Tell us about that.
It was an amazing trip. We went with the Department of Tourism, and we were promoting the culinary scene in the Philippines, and I learned some things I had never thought I knew.
You're teaching me how to make something today, which I love.
Yes.
And also has a similarity to the Philippines.
It does. Poke. Mm-hmm. Poke. And you pronounce it poke.
Poke. So
yes.
It's not poke. It's
no,
not pokey.
Not poke. Poke.
Okay. Poke.
Yeah. Which means poke. To cut, cube, or slice. So you have all different types of poke. Mm-hmm. Today I'm going to make you a basic ahi poke. I went fishing this morning for this. Look at this beautiful color on this.
No wonder
ahi.
You smell like that.
Yeah, I took a shower too. Can you cut some green onions for me?
Yeah.
You know how to cut green onions?
Of course.
Do this you cook at home?
Don't ask my husband that. This is a very sharp knife, so
yeah,
I'm just going to do it nice
be careful.
And slow.
Yeah.
Right.
And I'm going to do, you notice I got two different colors of fish here. Mm-hmm. I was here last month. I did a couple of pop-up dinners in Berkeley.
Mm-hmm.
Can you pass me your bowl?
And
there?
Is that going to continue on into 2020?
As long as people keep coming, yes, I'm going to keep doing them.
Well,
hopefully.
Well, you guys are sold out half the time, so
we
I
are.
Think people are still going to keep coming for sure.
She never comes to any of my pop-up dinners.
Yes,
but that's
I
okay.
do.
All
yes,
right, put
I
your
do.
Bowl
okay.
in the middle of the table.
All right.
Now. So this is really simple. If you're at home, first of all, I want to just show you this real quick. This is what we call seaweed
mm-hmm.
or limu. It's dry, so I'm going to drop it in water. Okay.
Mm.
And what it's going to do is in 30 seconds, it's going to rehydrate itself. And then I got some crab.
Okay.
And this is just
Delicious.
For you because I know you like crab.
Oh my God.
I usually don't put crab in my poke
uh-huh.
unless I have it, unless it's available. I won't go out of my way to get it, but here you can put it on your side.
Thank you for going out of your way.
All right.
I'm going to put the rest in mine,
just
right?
break it up a little bit like this so you get some in every bite. What I got here in this bowl here is Hawaiian salt and chili pepper.
Mm.
So I just want you to grab grab three pinches like that.
Mm-hmm.
And you can get Hawaiian salt anywhere. And I just put chili pepper, red chili pepper, and diced them up. And then what I'm going to do is I got masago,
mm-hmm.
which is the egg. I'm going to just take half of this.
Okay.
I'll give you the other half.
Thank you.
Just like that. Mm. We chopped up some onions here.
I love masago, can I just say?
Go put all of it in there.
Yes.
And then you can put all of this onion in there.
Uh-huh.
All right. And this, the magic secret sauce, this sesame oil, just put half of this. Just go like that. Just put half. Don't put
okay.
all of it. All right. So what I'm going to do here is, you see the seaweed?
Mm-hmm.
How it's got all popped up like that? It's alive now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to chop it up like this.
Mm-hmm.
This is for you. And then you can put that in yours. Go ahead. Grab that. But spread it apart. So I just...
I love the texture.
You see how it hydrated though? But look how
yeah.
fluffy it is.
Love
so
the
this
texture
is called ogo.
Uh-huh.
In Hawaii, we call it ogo from the Japanese.
May I?
Or limu, which is Hawaiian.
Mm.
And if you notice, a lot of different ethnicities or a lot of different races have their own poke.
Mm.
Did you notice that?
I did.
Because you have kilauen, which is your poke. The Spanish have ceviche. Put some of these in here too. Now we're just going to mix this.
This I can do.
Yeah.
This looks delicious. I love the limu.
So just mix it up. But what you want to do is just taste it real quick and make sure you have enough sesame oil
uh-huh.
and that salt.
Well,
so really, it's really up to you.
And while I taste it, then why don't you tell us what the rest of 2020 has in store for you?
Well, mm-hmm. Hopefully you'll come back and do more pop-ups.
Mm-hmm.
How was it going?
Hawaiian salt. Oh my God, that's delicious.
You taste it? You
mm-hmm.
taste that Hawaiian salt? How
I
about
do.
Your sesame oil? You okay on the oil?
I think I'm okay on the oil.
Okay, you're okay on
yeah.
the oil.
Yeah, it's
and
delicious.
That's it.
And then what about the nori?
Oh, so what we're going to do is we're going to just plate it.
Okay.
Grab your plate.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got to make it nice, okay?
Oh my God, I love this.
You
got to
make
this every day.
Nice. So when you plate, just grab put it right in the middle of there of your nori.
Okay.
Like that.
Okay.
All
other
right.
Other trips to the Philippines, more about the Philippines
yes.
kind of creeping up on taking its place on the culinary map.
It is huge. I think the Philippines is the next Mexican or Korean food. It has so much amazing flavors. Mm-hmm. I got this for you too, by the way. I know you drink coffee.
Oh, thank you
this
so much.
You.
Oh,
yeah.
The pride of the islands. I love it. Thank
coffee.
You so much. I need that coffee.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you,
you got some limo in your tea.
Yeah, that always happens.
Just kidding.
Right.
You don't have nothing in your tea.
Thank you. Aloha, Lanai. It's
Thanks
always great to
me.
See you. This is my favorite ever.
Good
All on. Right. Maraming salamat.